talk about being an artist and living off the grid. Things that can help you live on very little money. Choices you can make. So, right now, currently, I'm living in this 8x11 room. I'm doing that because I can't go home because of the COVID-19. And in this studio, there's shared spaces, shared bathroom, and someone was infected, so I thought it'd be best to chill for a couple weeks. I did rent a hotel room for a few days just to get off the floor and get some showering in, which was nice. Here's how I'm doing it though. I've had, check this out, you know, one of these Thermarests. You know, I've been on a yoga mat. I had a yoga lesson from a friend, and those things are great. Like the padding that they have for how thick it is, that would be ideal to crash on a floor that's basically just cement or cement over a tiny bit of carpet, which is what I'm dealing with here. I've done this twice. I think it was 2012. I was homeless because I had a bedbug infestation that I moved into this building in Minneapolis that was just infested. I was like wondering what the hell these bites were, and I was basically a meal for these things every day. And I'm like, you guys are douches. And then I saw some reviews of the place that they have bed bugs, and you know, I'm like, I'm not handling this. I'm out of here. So I left, and even though I didn't have a place to live, I'm just like, screw this, screw them. It was a month-to-month situation. Cheap rent, obviously. I know why. Anyway, so I don't know how many weeks I had nowhere to live, but it was uncomfortable. You know, you wonder where to go. You just take for granted that you always have a home to go to, and then when you don't, it's just like, what now? You're kind of living in a backpack, and you know, your stuff's in storage, whatever stuff you have left, and you're just like, you gotta find places to piss that are comfortable. You gotta find the right, you know, bathrooms that have locked doors so you can do like a hobo shower, you know. It sucks. And then, you know, I was doing that homeless thing for a good couple months, but I think somewhere between that, I started renting a studio space, you know, a rehearsal space, and I crashed the floor. Floor there. Now, in addition to, you know, one of these Thermarests back then, I would just use this padded case. You know, I like pad it out like that, and it's like an additional bit of padding there, and I was just like, it made it less stressful on my bony tailbone that would get really sore if I didn't do that. And that's what I'm doing now too as well. Like, besides the Thermarest, I have my amp covers. I have two of them, one for the extension cab and then one here. So I put that on top of the Thermarest, and then that, one of these, and then one of these memory foam car seats I put on my butt Because the tailbone just wants to embed into this cement and give you a bruise when you're as thin as I am. So you can do it. You're not going to get great sleep. But some nights when you're really tired, you will sleep pretty well. I mean, so there's that. You can do it. It'll be a little uncomfortable. And yeah, back to being an artist. I'm such a loner, you know. I'm great being alone. So this pandemic came about, and it was hardly an adjustment to me. And also, this is kind of a well-known fact. Like, Scandinavian Minnesotan were unbelievably protective of our distancing anyway. I've kind of noticed that. And then when I was away for a couple years down south and came back, I'm like, wow, people really hold their space, their personal space, in high regard. And, you know, hold land. Artistry again, right? Living off the grid. Okay, honestly, when I go to a grocery store, there's a few things that always pass through my head. Like, if I'm going to like a Cub or a Kroger, if it were down south, it's basically the way I eat and the things I consume. I try to be as organic, and a lot of green vegetables. I do eat some meat. I'll eat some chicken and some fish, and once in a while some grass-fed beef. But that's pretty much it. Pork makes me sick. Processed meat, I just know it's one of the worst things to eat. And it stresses your body out. Your body doesn't really know how to cope with it very well. So you're challenging your body when it needlessly can be using its energy elsewhere. That's how I feel. Now, back to the grocery stores. When I go in, I'm like, basically 95% of that, everything on the shelf to me is poison. Poison. Like, every brand that I've been brought up on has no conscience anymore, and they're using the Roundup wheat, which no other country will touch. Causes cancer. Come on. I had a cousin who had a bakery, and one of his workers developed an allergy, and it's like, you know what? An allergy to gluten. Couldn't even go near this stuff anymore. It's real. I mean, celiac disease, and people are getting allergies to gluten because of the greed of Monsanto, right? But yeah, basically, so many things I will not touch. I read every label, and if there's too many preservatives, no way. But a couple things I always will have on stock as staples, and that's like organic soups, like a chicken with wild rice soup. It's a cheap one at Cub, you know, for like $2.50 for a 17-ounce can. And that's quick. You can do that while you're working whatever job and just chug a can of that. And I mean, not every meal has to be an elaborate great thing, you know. Just keep it simple. Make a good food that's not challenging your body, so you got the energy you need to be creative, to do the work you need to do, to have your mind clear. If I'm eating crappy stuff and I feel terrible, I get anxiety. Like, and I'm like, why am I anxious all of a sudden? It's because my body's like, what are you doing? And my body's connected to my mind, right? You know, like, your gut is your second mind. Many scientists are leaning towards that mentality. I'm going to pause this for a second. Are we still in grocery stores? There are vegetables that I just feel I cannot afford. I've been below poverty and way below some years. And when I go into a grocery store and I want things, and it makes me want to throw things off the shelf. But at the same time, I'm like, you know, fuck this society. I mean, fuck it. It does not work for artistic types that don't want to sell out their integrity and be like everybody else. It's not made for anybody but the top 0.1%. And that ruling class, I feel, has manipulated the rest of the population to fight each other. And so if someone is actually doing somewhat well, they're going to judge poor people and condemn them. And they're not doing that great compared to people that are billionaires, you know, almost trillionaires. So it's just, I look at the wage gap and then I look at what's a living wage, considered a living wage. I think it's ridiculous. If you look at what the inflation rate is and what it has been since like the 60s, I don't even know, but I think a minimum wage should be today like around $27 an hour, but it's not. And I think it's disgusting. I think to pay someone $9 an hour for the time is like a kick to the nuts and a kick to the vagina, whatever you have, and kick to the face, spitting in your face. You know, I get a little worked up about it, and I don't think I would feel differently if I was actually doing well. And I'm with those that struggle, you know. I'm not ashamed. I'm neither ashamed nor proud. But I am happy that I'm aware and not deluded and not ignorant, as far as I'm concerned. This is probably going to have to be a 2-3-part thing, but are we back to the grocery stores again and the food there? Let's see. What can I quickly tell you? Yes. So I want to throw stuff around a lot of times when I'm frustrated because I can't afford them. Like, I can't afford broccoli. I can't afford, you know, quite a few vegetables. Like, but kale I can find on sale. Even organic kale, I'll get a big bunch of that and it'll be a great deal. Like those packaged, you know, smaller and larger salad greens. I mean, for one, it's the plastic thing, and it really bums me out that we're just getting so back to plastic with the whole COVID-19. But I guess that's the reality of what's going on. But yeah, bulk is always a good idea. And if they got it out there, kale is fairly affordable. I need carrots so I can see better. I'll get organic carrots. They're still affordable. Sometimes potatoes are reasonable. Sweet potatoes, I get them all the time because they're superfoods. Spinach, I'll eat in moderation. I don't eat as much as I used to because you can't absorb the calcium.